Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough 4-5 Chomp Rock Zone. So we've got a Chomp Rock and we've got to keep it as long as possible, just like I hinted at the end of the last parts. Roll it as just a Chomp Rock, roll it as far as you can and see what happens. And this is the brown variety of Chomp Rock, so if you get it stuck, it's stuck permanently until you restart the level, so let's not do anything too hasty with this Chomp Rock here. Just kind of relax, maybe even set up the paths for it ahead of time at points. That seems like a good idea to do, but also we're still going to need it to kind of pass by some stuff without having to use a ton of eggs. I'll just kind of smoosh that down just in case there's something in there. Let's just take a look-see up here. Nope, nothing hidden. Basically, the idea of this level is to use the Chomp Rock to get places that you wouldn't otherwise be able to get to. And you definitely need it for the very last area type place, but, well, we'll get into that if we go... Well, I don't want to jump down there, because that's just gonna... Uh-oh. Oh, shoot. Oh no. Did I just mess up? Oh, maybe not. Okay. I forgot this was down here. Okay. What we're supposed to do here is kick this to the left, I believe. We were not supposed to kick that to the left. Yeah, you're supposed to get it through that. Whoops! And then this is gonna do a shell chain and then kill all those down there for a one-up. I was supposed to do ground pound this out first and then use the shell. Can I get it to respawn? Probably not. Nah, because it popped on that tap-tap. Okay. Well, that's okay, I guess. Just as long as I don't miss 100%ing, I will be a happy Yoshi. And there's only a one up there, so no problemo. Ooh, oh! Oh, it appeared with the Chomp Rock! It stars! Yay! And we're off. Woo! I'll just follow it along. I don't think there's anything that I need to set it up for this time. I'm gonna pound these all the way down, even though I don't think there's anything behind it. No. And I'm also mandatorily gonna have to pound this down and shoot this, because otherwise the Chomp Rock gonna get stuck in that little alcove down there, and then we won't be able to progress. This is another thing here. I don't want to get the Chomp Rock all the way to here, because it'll get stuck. I need to use it to get up there. Well, actually, maybe I don't. Watch this. I think I could just go over that post. Probably. Oh, I said probably. Nope. Maybe I can't. I guess I gotta wait for a Shy Guy to go all the way over there, like, by walking, but that would take forever and a half, so let's not do that. Let's just kind of shimmy along there until I get... Well, until I get some headroom, I guess. And there we go. Voila. Now, I don't need that, like, to push it on this side or anything like that there, right? I don't think it's even possible to get it over there, but I just wanted to see if maybe I forgot something that... Because, yeah... Oh, it is possible to get over there. Look at that. Interesting. Interesting. Okay. I'm just gonna push it back down here, which will automatically crash through, because it's gonna use up its only means of cracking through there. And you can sort of kind of break through the Koopa Brigade here with using your delightfully chompy friend. I need that. Okay. There's a midpoint, but I'm not really keen about hitting that midpoint. Unless I have to, like, if I can't avoid it. The reason why I don't want to hit it is because if I... Okay, there we go. I was gonna say, because I think I still need this rock to go further on ahead, and restarting the level, like, why did I do that? That was just stupid. It was too close to being directly above my head. But yeah, I think I need that rock to be make it all the way to the end. So I'm just gonna skip that midpoint, I think. Because I think if I restart from that midpoint, I won't get that rock back. I could be wrong about that, though, but just for the sake of completion, let's just keep that going. Because this level isn't really all that dangerous otherwise. It's just a thing of that you gotta make sure that you keep that Chomp Rock as long as you can. And I think I can take it now. It seems safe enough. Just want to make sure that it's not to the point that it's going to be a no-go. Like that you can't do anything about it after a certain point. Because there is a point where you absolutely need to set up posts for it to roll across with some bridges. So it's a matter of looking ahead, and that's what I've been trying to do this whole time, just to make sure that I don't ever lose track and position of my Chomp Rock to an impossible position, basically. And oh, I can't get up there. I have no assistance of a rock. Okay, this is the run, I think, that I need to use a bridge. And so we need to pound these poles down only far enough to make a bridge for the rock. And then we gotta use it to get... there's the red coins. We need to use it to get up top there, basically. Got it? Good. Alright. So that's all fine and dandy, if I can do this properly. I mean, I set everything up nicely. It's just going to be a matter of doing this smoothly. So we're gonna use this, give it a little bit of forward momentum. Hit that. And with the maximum speed, we're gonna push, 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 push! And... oh shoot, oh shoot! Okay, we're good. We are good. But there's another Chomp Rock section after this. And it's only through these doors. So we're still not done. And you know, I didn't get that midpoint too, so... So yeah, that's where the other door would normally lead you, but you still need the Chomp Rock, so that's why you need to come through that door, because... oh, shoot, I didn't notice you had your flowers back. I should say balls back. That's okay, though. So yeah, I needed this rock, and I see this. Can you see that? You can see that now. It's a flower. Alrighty. Anything up here? No? Okay. We're moving along with the groove on. Still being extra careful with our rock so as to not push it down any sort of cliff that I cannot get it back from. Yeah. Heavy. Heavy. Okay. Careful. Careful. I'm tempted to just, like, go hog wild with that rock sometimes, but no, you can't do that. And I'm not going down that pipe, because I think that'll reset the rock. At least I think you might be able to go down that pipe. Whoops. Hold on a sec. Did I see something up there? I hope that wasn't a red coin shy guy or a fly guy. I hope. Unless there was just something... Anyway, I need to make this bridge to get that Chomp Rock up. Oh, that's the end of the Chomp Rock. I just need to get it down and underneath that area then. Okay. And then I will have to abandon my chompy friend. Except I'm not really sure it's even sentient to call it a friend, but who knows? Who knows? Oh, Jiggly, right? Jiggly. Ground pound it and hold down. And push it to the wall relatively close. There you go. That's the last red coin. So there wasn't a red coin shy guy like I feared. Let's just see here. What's this? A one up? What's this? It's a secret! It's a flower! Okay, so obviously I gotta do that. And then I gotta do this. And then hopefully time this well. There we go. Puzzle completed. And I probably couldn't get those stars. But I think I'm at max stars anyway. Oh no, I'm not. Wow. Why did I think I was at max stars? I didn't get that many stars and I took some hits. Come to think of it. Any secrets? Any secrets? Out of my way. You two. And you three, even though I think you're the same one. Alright, so I guess that is it. I guess I will use my 10s then. Just to make sure that... well, maybe I should use the 20, I don't know. Because I could use the 10s on the times that I don't need a 20, but... the 20s are just more versatile, and 10s are more common. So that's it! That is it. 100% complete. But we get a bonus game. Yeah. I don't even know if you could call the bonus challenges the challenges when they're luck-based. Well, I should say some of them are luck-based. Not all of them are luck-based, but... Yeah, but if you get one that is luck-based, it's definitely not a challenge so much as it is a, hey, yeah, let's just play some roulette. Literally. Alright, so since I got a massive amount of lives like usual, we're playing for 99. Let's see what we can get. Can I get a times 2? That would be exciting. A times? Uh-oh. I lost 99 lives. Oh, well. Nothing of value was lost. And with that, I'm gonna end off the part here. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part we do, 4-6, The Return of the Cheap Cheap / Floppy Fish. I don't know where they got the name Floppy Fish from when they're clearly Cheap Cheeps.